suppose nothing. I got enough calcium in me for 7 sets of teeth.
You know, I'd give $4 for a skinny little hot dog right now.
Milk. If it's so good, why do cows give it away?
Personally, I adore milk.
To bathe in.
You'll drink it and like it.
How come they have so much when the butcher stores have so little?
Hi, what you got?
Hi, girls. Pull up some flab and sit down. I see you finished the coconut custard pie.
It really hit the spot.
How could I miss that target? Can't stop inflation, can they?
I saw that cream pie yesterday.
No, it was cream pie yesterday. Today is cheesecake.
What about these chocolate bars?
Oh, can't do it. That stuff belongs to the Army. This is what I'm selling, and it'll certainly start your second front.
Huh?
I mean third.
Say, those eclairs you sold us didn't have any filling in them. They were just empty shells.
Well, I'm not the man I was either. Say, how about some non-fattening chocolate coconut cream bars? It'll make your stomach laugh right out loud.
Non-fattening? It can't be.
Oh, now, you've got to have a little faith in me.
The heaven, sheer heaven.
Heaven can wait. They're a buck and a half.
Plainly marked right there on the box. 25 cents.
It can't be plainly marked. I tried to rub it out. It's synthetic rubber.
But $1.50 for a 25-cent box is robbery.
Lady, you wouldn't want to cheat me out of the sales tax, would you? Besides, look at all the fun you can have for $1.50 and the chance I'd take bootlegging this stuff to you gals. Why, if a certain party ever caught me, why, I'd be just be... Shoo, shoo. Go away, duck, blow. It's a raid. Back to your hangers. Go ahead, spread out. Go ahead.
So... you're the one that's been stuffing those two turkeys.
Well, how dare you? We don't have to stand here and be insulted for our good $8 a day.
No, there's a place down the road where you can be insulted for $2 a day. Oh. I'll see you inside.
Yes, honey. At least leave the Jeep, huh? Now, don't holler at me.
Don't holler at you when
now,
you
please,
come around here selling candy,
you.
Jerry. I don't understand. You're going to get me fired, Jerry. Here, I'm trying to trim those blimps down, and you come along and blow them up again.
Well, you take it off, I'll put it on. They'll stay here longer.
I was so happy yesterday because I got one of them to bend over and touch her knees. Now she can't even see her knees.
Well, I'm doing it all for you. How do you expect us to get married Sunday if I don't make a little extra dough?
Don't tell me it's still on for Sunday. Isn't this the time of the week it usually gets postponed?
Not this time, baby. This time we marry.
Yeah, I've been hearing that for 8 weeks running. First you get quarantined in camp, then your leave got canceled, then my leave got canceled, then your leave got canceled.
Then I got poison ivy.
My trousseau's worn out just from packing and unpacking.
Yeah, I know. Your bridal gown has made the trip to Camp Arthur so often, you could stand it up in the road and it would walk there by itself.
What am I laughing at?
Say, Winnie, baby, before you come out to camp tonight, you gotta go into town.
What for?
Well, you gotta get our wedding ring out of hock.
Jerry, you don't mean you hocked the wedding ring even before the wedding.
Well, we had to pay for the marriage license, didn't we?
Yes, and where do we get the money to bail the wedding ring out?
Well, we hocked the engagement ring. We're already engaged. We don't need that anymore.
Oh, and I suppose after the ceremony, we hocked the wedding ring to pay the minister.
Oh, that's a great idea. I was wondering how I was gonna pay him off.
Gee, do you suppose he'll ever live long enough to get both of those rings on the same finger at the same time?
Oh, sure. Of course, we may have to spend our honeymoon in the pawn shop, but it'll work out.
Yes, well, I bought a little wedding present for you that you can't hock.
Well, what good is it?
Well, you remember the night we had dinner at Chili Chili's?
Yeah, that was the night I got that terrible attack of indigestion.
That was the night you asked me to marry you.
Well, whatever it was, it sure kept me awake all night. I couldn't sleep a wink. I was just...
Do you remember number 8 on the jukebox?
Yeah, when I found out you liked it, I played it over and over. Where'd you get all those nickels?
Oh, be quiet and listen. I made a record of that song.
Yeah?
I've never done this before.
That's me.
It's very simple. Just
sit down.
Closer to the microphone. There.
I said it couldn't happen to me, which only proves how wrong you can be.
Is that you?
Uh-huh.
Well, you gotta hit me with that in person.
But who did? I did. Yes, I did. I said there'd be no bride and no Jew.
The rhyme is moon.
To take that well-known route to the moon. I said I never would start to dream, but who did? I did. Yes, I did. I'm so in love. And after all my promises, one kiss and I glow.
Oh, naturally.
Love takes care of darling Thomases. Ask me, I know. If I could just be sure you were mine, I'd give my heart that go-ahead sign. I said I never would fall in love, but who did? I did.
You did?
Yes, I did.
Now try one just a little louder.
Okay. Who said that?
Who cares?
I never thought that I was a square, that someday I'd be walking on air. I never thought I would fall for you, but who did?
You did.
That I did. I used to tell myself I was strong. But I went weak when you came along. I said I'd never get off the beam, but who did?
You did.
Yes, I did. I'm on your hook, and playing fish is fun for me. I never felt greater. Look what loving you has done for me. I'll have it set later.
Imagine parking us here while they go fishing.
What do you mean fishing? I'll
Shh,
bet that they...
Don't make any cracks now.
Looks like a lovely place, darling.
Well, get a good rest, dear. Yes.
Well, goodbye, Maggie, my dear. We'll pick you up Sunday.
Better hurry. That fish is waiting for you.
Oh, we're holding up the bus.
Yeah, we gotta pick up the bait.
What do you use? Live worms that wiggle?
Yes, live red-headed worms.
That's a good one.
Well, goodbye, dear. Goodbye.
Well, goodbye, Maggie, my dear.
Well, goodbye, Julian, my dear.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Bonnie, dear.
Goodbye.
Fine thing, putting us out to pasture so they can go cutie chasing.
I can't believe Henry would do such a thing.
Oh, you can't, eh? Well, don't think just because your husband's a judge, he's above suspicion.
What do you think judges do in their chambers?
Telling us they're going fishing. I'll eat every fish they catch and eat it raw.
If we only knew just where they were going, we might be able to do something about it.
Henry wouldn't dare go there, would he?
Where?
What are you talking about?
No, that's impossible.
Speak up. What's impossible?
Well, you know our summer place at Southampton.
Yeah.
Well, we haven't used it for months. But the other day, I overheard Henry asking the maid for the keys.
Well, why didn't you say so?
That's where they're going. Oh, but they said that we could call them tonight at Montauk Point.
Oh, that's just to throw us off the track. They'll probably take their cuties out to the house tomorrow.
Right, and we'll be there to welcome them.
But that was our honeymoon cottage. Henry wouldn't take anyone there.
He took you there, didn't he?
Yes, that's what we'll do. We'll drive out to Southampton early in the morning, so we'll be there when they arrive.
We'll give them a little reception they'll never forget.
I don't know whether to greet them with shotguns or lawyers.
The dogs. How would they like it if we went gallivanting around with some baby-faced Romeos?
Huh? That's it? That's just what we'll do.
What? Did I say something?
You sure did. I'll show that middle-aged Henry Aldrich of mine that I can buy my way into kindergarten, too.
It's an idea. If we can make them jealous, they might learn to appreciate us.
Isn't it dangerous?
Look, Cornelia, our husbands aren't much, but they're the only ones we've got, and we're going to hold on to them if we can. Of course, we haven't got the grip we used to have.
Come to think of it, we haven't got the little boyfriends either.
Yeah, that's right. Oh, but we ought to be able to buy, borrow, or steal some young males somewhere.
The only young males around here are calves.
Oh, I don't know. Hello.
Oh, hello, girls. Have you finished grazing yet? How long are you in for it?
We're expecting a pardon any minute. Come here.
Me?
You're a soldier, aren't you?
Oh, no. But wait a minute. I'm an American soldier. I'm on your side.
Now, sit down, soldier. I want to ask you some questions.
Huh?
What do you do with your spare time?
Oh, you know about that, huh? I know just what you want, girls.
My, things certainly get around fast, don't they?
Oh, you're not the only ones. I got plenty of customers in here. I really should have an assistant, but I like to take care of everybody personally.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I saw him first, girl.
Yeah, but what about us?
Well, I got a wonderful line of assorted kisses.
It sounds peachy, doesn't it?
Just ducky.
Yes, and there's one piece of cheesecake left and some almond bars. I think. Look, my truck's parked right around the corner.
Wait a minute. Just what are you selling?
Well, candies, chocolates, and pastries.
Oh, no. We don't want any of that.
Well, what are we talking about?
You look like a young man with an eye to business. How'd you like to make yourself $100?
$100? Look, ladies, I don't know a thing about the Norden bomb site. I'm just a little man with...
Oh, this is a little personal matter. Now, I have a job for you.
And can you get a couple of other nice boys for us?
For $100 a head, I can get you the whole company.
We'll settle for three.
We really should have a special price for three.
Well, what is this project? What do we have to do? And what do we do with the body after we do it?
We simply want you to spend Sunday with us.
Oh, we have a lovely house and plenty to eat and drink.
Oh, I'm sorry, lady. If you expect me to carry on an affair de coeur, I can't do it.
Why not?
I don't know what it means.
Now, there's nothing to be afraid of.
Look, girls, why don't you stop taking vitamin pills and forget this whole thing, huh, girls?
You're throwing away a chance to make some easy money.
Well, what's so easy about it? Besides, I've got a girl, and that's good enough for me. What do you think I am, a wolf?
I just feel old. Here's our 2 o'clock feeding.
I've unpacked you if you'd like to get into your play suit.
Oh, but we haven't anyone to play with. By the way, where did that soldier boy come from?
Camp Arthur. There are 20,000 of them there.
20,000?
20,000 lonesome boys. Yum, yum.
A lot of us girls go over and dance with them every Saturday afternoon.
Why, that's today.
Girls, we have a patriotic duty to perform.
It's the call to arms. You better pack up our things again.
You're not staying?
No, we're enlisting.
Yes, home defense work.
We'll stop on the way and pick up some cigarettes and stuff for the boys. Say, you know, I'm going to enjoy this defense work.
Don't confuse the issue. You know what we're going to defend. Let's get to it.
My girl gave me these black and whites.
I got this, but it never lights.
Hey, my girl gave me these songs by Bing.
I got what I asked for, this yo-yo thing.
My girl gave me this dial to twist.
Uncle Sam needs you, and you should enlist.
Hold it! Face it, we're on the beat, drawing a soldier's pay. Every day. Each week and pass, each day to the last, to be cooked with gas, yeah, ma'am. So let's face it, it's not so tough, dropping it for Uncle Sam.
When you join up, you don't go wrong. The army builds them so big and strong.
You go through flames, steel, and even mud.
Before they're done, you're fearless.
Blood.
Let's face it,
We're on the move, drawing a soldier's band.
Hello, baby. Gee, I'm glad to see you. We've been here. Sweetie.
Oh, it's good to see you.
Gee, you look fine.
Yeah, I put on a couple of pounds since last week.
Good. Now your face looks like something I can get the teeth in.
You too.
Hey, is that the wedding present for Jerry?
Yes, and I'm getting tired of lugging it back and forth.
Oh, it's all set now.
Seen Private Walker?
No, sir.
Private Walker drive up yet with a truckload of supplies?
Not yet, Sergeant.
Well, where is he?
Well, we don't know.
Ah, that irresponsible sap. You can't depend on him. This is the Army, not a golf course. When a man gets an order in the Army, nothing should stand in his way. He should see that those supplies get here, even if he has to drive through the side of the building.
Private Walker reporting for guardhouse duty, sir.
Come out of there! Come here!
Guess we better call the insurance company.
I've been in the service 15 years. And in all my experience, I've never run into anyone so incompetent. Stop that horn! Stop that horn! Stop that horn! Come on!
And no pig-headed first sergeant's gonna... Oh, I'm sorry, sir. I apologize. In the future, I'll think those things to myself.
You will, huh? You'll think those things to yourself.
I said, stop that horn! I said, stop that horn! You killed me! Stop that horn!
You stupid idiot. You wreck an Army Jeep, you crash through the side of a building, and you apologize. Do you realize what these repairs will cost?
Well, if the government will take it out of my pay, I can charge it off my income tax.
They'll take it out of your pay, all right. And they'll put you in a place where you don't need money. How do you like that? Oh.
Does this mean you forgive me, Sergeant?
Why?
Damaged post exchange wall, $40. Repairs to candy counter, $8. Total destruction of 8 boxes of gumdrops. 16 cartons of chocolate bars with nuts. 112 assorted lollipops and 6 cans of peanut brittle, also with nuts. $19.60, making a grand total of $204.10. Now, Private Walker, what do you suggest I do with this bill?
Send it to my draft board. They got me into this.
Oh, I'm afraid you'll have to take care of it yourself. Otherwise, your Uncle Sammy might get very angry and write you a nasty lawyer letter. Now, you wouldn't want him to do that, would you?
Oh, no. I'll pay for the damage, Sergeant, but you'll have to give me a little time.
Time? Oh, yes, I think that can be arranged. Let's say, 6 months? In the guardhouse, unless you pay this bill.
Oh, but Sarge, have a heart. Where would I get 200 bucks?
Oh, that's your little problem, Private Walker.
Does this mean my weekend leave is canceled?
It means you're confined to quarters until we get around to court-martialing you. Now get back to work on that Jeep and leave it where it is. I want the captain to see it.
Yeah, but I'm supposed to get married tomorrow.
Oh, in that case, I'll reserve the honeymoon suite in the guardhouse for you and the little bride.
Is the sentry a married man?
Oh, yes, he's a...
Hey, there's too much competition around here.
We may have to find some civilians. Who'd we know in 4F?
I wish I'd worn my hat with the veil.
Excuse me, ladies. Well, the 3 Rover girls. Well, what's cooking beside your bloodstream?
Crawl back under your rock, you worm.
Why don't you try the Navy? Maybe they'll go... Hey, wait a minute. I want to talk to you.
We're not buying any lollipop, soldier.
Yeah, well, look, I've been thinking over that proposition of yours about wanting companions tomorrow.
Oh, no, we want clean ones.
Oh, well, don't worry, this stuff comes right off. I know a couple other fellows who are awfully hard up for dough. No, I mean, what they wouldn't do for 100 bucks. No, I...
Why don't you just take a deep breath and start all over?
Yeah, well, I'd like to hear a little more about the deal. Maybe the facts ain't as bad as the figures.
Well, facts are very simple. We've a lovely home at Southampton. But what's a home without the pitter-patter of little boys like you?
300 bucks for pitter-patter? Ain't there a ceiling?
Oh, it'll be so cozy. Just the 6 of us.
No chaperone?
Chaperone? What for? We're old enough to take care of ourselves.
Yeah, but we ain't.
Well, couldn't you learn?
300 bucks. Bingo.
Oh, no. This has got to be COD.
Well, really, lady, I'll be in a much happier mood if I can get the money in advance.
You might lose it by tomorrow. The mood, I mean. Here, I'll give you a $50 deposit.
And this is the address. You and the other boys be over as early as possible tomorrow afternoon.
Now, don't disappoint us, you little darling.
Easy, lady. You're running into overtime.
What's your name?
Oh, Jerry Walker. And when I arrive, pay me the money and I'll give the boys their share.
Huh? It'll save a lot of embarrassment and a lot of explaining and a lot of money.
Oh, here you are. Will you come with me, please? Sergeant Wiggins wants to thank you for supplying all those nice things for the boys.
And we want to thank Sergeant Wiggins for supplying all these nice things for us.
Hey, what do you got there?
Oh, no, just some pictures of presidents I'm saving.
What do the sergeants say?
Oh, plenty. I'm in an awful jam, fellas.
Hey, anything we can do?
Yeah, I need lots of money. This time, money talks. How much dough you got?
I got about $3. Yeah, I got 2.5.
You haven't even started to whisper yet. Unless I can raise about $30, it's a guardhouse for me.
Gee, that's too bad.
Boy, I sure wish we could help you.
Well, there is something you can do, but I really don't like to ask you.
Well, we're your pals, ain't we?
Yeah, but this ain't no ordinary job.
Jerry, to get you out of this jam, I'd kiss a pig.
You may have to.
What do you mean?
Yeah, what's on your mind?
Well, come on in here and I'll tell you all about it.
Hi, Jerry.
I left it down. Put it down. Look, how would you like to spend all day Sunday at a beautiful home in the Sound, all you can eat, all you can drink, and get $10 apiece besides? Huh?
Can we bring our girls?
No, no, that's taken care of, too.
Hey, I don't get it. You mean we get eats and drinks and dames, and we get $10 apiece?
That's right. Nothing to do, and we get big money. It's a big rainbow with three pots at the end of it.
Well, who pays the $10?
The dames.
Why?
For expenses. They're patriotic. They want to do something for us soldiers.
Oh, it's a sort of a new kind of a USO.
Yeah, in a way.
Yeah, but there's something screwy about three dames that want to pay us to spend a day with them.
Oh, well, you see, they're kind of lonesome, you know, stuck way out there all by themselves in a big house. It's rough.
Oh, you mean we have to neck with them?
Well, maybe a little, but what have you got to lose?
Hey, now, wait a minute. What do they look like?
Well, oh, the one. Oh, she's looks like Madeline Carroll, Dorothy L'Amour, and Claudette Colbert all rolled up into one big lump. That's yours.
Hey, now, don't take me for granted. But it ain't bad.
And yours. Oh, but she's sort of a Veronica Lake with two eyes and a figure like Paulette Goddard.
Gee, all that and $10, too.
Hey, but wait a minute. That means we got to break our dates with Muriel and Jane. Besides, how'll that help you out of your jam?
Oh, don't you see? I'll have $30 when you fellas lend me the 20 you get.
Don't tell me that damage amounted to only $30.
Oh, no, that's just the down payment. The rest will come out of my pay for the next few years. What do you say, fellas? Will you do it?
Well, okay. But you got to promise to pay us back that dough.
Oh, I give you my word. I'll even swear to it with my hand on a 3-hour pass. One more thing, though. Sergeant Wiggins put me under arrest in quarters. I got to figure some way of getting out of here.
Yeah, fine time for you to get caught AWOL.
Well, I don't intend to get caught. That's what I got to figure out.
Ain't you in enough trouble already?
Oh, look, I'm as good a soldier as anybody. This is the only way I get to pay for the damage I've done.
Okay, wise guy, but don't get us in a jam.
Now, would I do a thing like that?
Yeah.
Hey, what about Winnie? We can't tell her about this little deal.
Well, I'll have to cook up some kind of a story. After all, I'm really doing all this for Winnie.
What are you doing for Winnie?
Oh, hello, baby.
Hello, Winnie.
Hi, say,
Winnie.
What happened?
A woman driver. Say, you're late. I was scared you weren't coming.
I missed the last bus and had to hitchhike in. I made up my mind that nothing was going to postpone our getting married this time.
Yeah.
Say, what are you wearing those things for? You're not in trouble again, Jerry.
Oh, no. I was just trying to find out what makes a Jeep go up and down instead of straight ahead.
Well, come on, Barney, let's find Muriel and Jean.
Yeah, we got to explain to them about tomorrow.
Yeah, well, don't explain too much and hurry back as soon as you can.
Yeah, bye, Winnie. Bye, Winnie. Whatever happens, Winnie, remember, it's all for your own good.
Get going, will you? Sit down, honey.
What are they talking about?
Oh, nothing, nothing at all. Say, you look sharp today.
Here's the license. And here's the ring. And here's the pawn ticket. Now you take over. I'm tired. Will you still do this after we're married?
Oh, Winnie, these are times when American womanhood must be prepared to make sacrifices.
I know. I'm marrying you, ain't I?
When duty calls, ours not to reason why, ours but to...
Skip the poetry. What are you leading up to?
Well, I'm going on special duty.
Well, what of it?
Well, I won't be back till late Sunday night. Too late.
Oh.
It's a tough break, honey.
Well, why don't you try and get out of it? Let them pick someone else for this special duty.
Well, they picked me because they figured I was the best man for the job. Would you want me to shirk it?
No, darling. You go and do your best.
Oh, that's a spirit.
I should have known. When I woke up this morning, I looked in the mirror and I said, so you think you're getting married tomorrow, huh? And I laughed right in my own face.
Well, it's all for the best, Winnie. Look, here's $50. Get that ring out of Hawk and buy yourself a trousseau.
Where did you get this?
Well, it's kind of a bonus.
Bonus? Don't they usually give medals?
Well, not for the work I've got to do.
Just what kind of a special assignment is this?
Well, I can't tell you that.
A military secret?
Yeah, it's a military secret.
Dangerous?
Well, men have been shot doing this type of work.
You will be careful, darling.
Oh, don't worry. Just take care of yourself. Well, I've got to leave right away.
Bye, darling.
You better call the Justice of the Peace and tell him it's all off again, huh?
I'll do it right away. Now, you do everything you're told, and maybe when you come back, you'll have stripes on that sleeve.
Yeah, stripes. I may have them all over me.
Oh, hello, girls.
Hello, Miss Potter.
Are you helping to entertain the boy?
Oh, little. I was rehearsing a song. I let him push me around the dance floor.
It's fun being pushed around, isn't it?
Say, I understand you girls walked out on the milk farm.
Well, when we heard about the wonderful work you girls were doing, we realized how selfish we were to be thinking just of ourselves.
Oh, are you three going to dance with the boys?
We're doing better than that. We're having the boys come out to dance with us.
Yes, we picked ourselves three little soldiers to entertain all day tomorrow.
I have a house at Southampton. They'll have a lovely time.
Well, lucky boys.
Oh, by the way, Miss Potter, are you going back to the milk farm?
I think so. Why?
Well, if any mail or telegrams come, please send them on to this address.
Supposing your husband should telephone, what will I tell them?
Tell them we're fishing, the same as they are. Goodbye, Miss Potter.
Where? Oh, Winnie.
Hi, Winnie.
Hi, kid.
Oh, I heard about the wedding being postponed again.
Well, that's how it is when you're engaged to a soldier.
Yeah, you never know when he's going to be called into action.
Oh, no, it's not that serious. We'll be back sometime tomorrow night.
Are you boys in on it, too?
All three of us.
Must be important. They're awfully mysterious about it.
Well, they have to be careful.
Sure, you know what they say. A slip of the lip will smear the lipstick, or...
Oh. We'll call you as soon as we get back tomorrow night.
Yeah, we're only going as far as Southampton, yeah. And...
Southampton, huh?
Can't you keep your big mouth shut?
I didn't say where in Southampton.
Oh, Jerry told me about it. He said there was some fifth column activities going on around there.
Yeah, maybe even sixth column.
He said there was some trained Japanese beetles going around spreading German measles.
That's right, and we got to put a stop to it.
Yes, we certainly have got to put a stop to it. You boys go and finish this dance out together. We got some business to talk over.
I hope this ketchup works. I'm beginning to feel like a hamburger.
That's enough. You're getting it all... Shh, Jiggers, here comes a sergeant.
Oh.
Easy now.
Oh. That's it. Take it slow.
Oh.
Easy.
How is he? Hurt bad?
I can't tell. He's losing a lot of blood.
Save it for the Red Cross.
Better send for an ambulance.
No. No, don't send for an ambulance. The boys can run me over to the hospital in a jeep.
Okay.
Take it easy,
huh?
We'll take care of him, Sarge.
Let me know what the doctor says.
Oh.
Yeah, we'll call you.
Oh.
All clear.
Hey, what'll I do with this bottle of ketchup?
Save it. You never know when we'll need more blood.
Are you sure this won't get us into trouble?
Oh, quit worrying, will you? I'll telephone the sergeant myself and tell him the doctor said I'd be laid up for a few days. Then when we get back from Southampton, I'll stick a piece of adhesive tape on my head and report back for duty.
But supposing he finds out you never checked into the hospital?
Yeah, that'll get us into trouble.
Yeah. Well, you fellas just say that you left me in front of the hospital.
Yeah, but what'll you say?
Well, I'll tell him I don't remember a thing. That bump in my head knocked me silly.
Okay, but it's your headache.
Lucky thing for you, the rear end of the jeep caved in.
What do you mean, lucky? What do you think I was working on all afternoon?
You mean you did that?
Oh, fool.
You better lay low so Wiggins don't see
you. Yeah. I'll meet you fellas tonight in front of that statue in the parade grounds, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, and don't get in any trouble.
He should be here.
there, Jerry.
Shh. Let's keep it all low, huh, fellas? Where'd you get gas after 7 o'clock, you sneak?
Swell place you picked for a conference.
Yeah, it couldn't be wide open.
Yeah, and if Sergeant Wiggins ever catches us, we'll all be yard birds.
Oh, quit worrying, will you? There's nobody here but these three men from Boys Town. What do you got in the basket?
Oh, I brought you some sandwiches and a pie in case you get hungry.
Oh, I love you dearly. Love pie. That's my meat.
Where are you going to spend the night?
In town. I'll pick you fellas up right after reveling. We'll head for Southampton.
Look at that woman. Wish I knew what we were in for.
Oh, it's really simple. All we have to do is amuse three women.
I thought they were supposed to amuse us.
Well, it works both ways. Half the time we amuse them and the other half of the time. Watch out.
Say, Jerry, I got an idea. These dames ain't going to want to play gin rummy.
I know. I'll bring along some phonograph records.
Yeah, maybe if we wear them out dancing, they'd be too tired to neck later, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, we've been good.
Hey, who's that?
Somebody's coming. Let's get out of
here. Oh, now, be careful. He might hear us.
Holy mackerel, it's Sergeant Wiggins.
With Winnie, why, I'll kill him.
No.
Are you kidding? Let me...
Isn't this the long way to the guest house, Sergeant?
Yeah. But it's such a beautiful moonlight night, I thought I'd be ashamed to waste it. Yeah. Let's sit down and talk a while, huh?
It's nice of you to take me around. The soldier who invited me up had some business to attend to.
Well, one man's feast, another man's famine, huh? You know, you're just the kind of a girl that I could go for in a...
A big way.
You sure have got that...
That thing.
Yeah.
Oh, Sergeant.
Look at the moon and the stars. Ah, what a wonderful night.
It certainly might have been.
Where have you been all my life, Miss Potter? Anything wrong?
Oh, no, nothing at all. Sergeant, tell me more about the moon and the stars.
Tell me, are you married or going steady or anything?
Oh, no, I'm as free as a mountain goat. My, Sergeant, what a strong man you are. How do you keep so fit? It must be the army life.
Oh, partly, yes. But the main reason is I watch my diet. Never eat desserts. Here, feel that.
My.
Why, would you believe it? I haven't had a piece of pie in my mouth in 15 years. Uh-huh!
Hey.
Wow.
Thanks for the lift, Mac.
Hey, soldier.
I mean Maxine.
How do you like that? And we were riding in the back. Gee, they do everything, don't they?
Yeah, good. Say, this is quite a pup tent for us dogs to bark in, huh?
Yeah, something tells me we're gonna wind up in a pound.
No, this is it.
Well, nobody home. Let's go.
Wait a minute. Give them time. Maybe they think we're from the FHA.
I'll go take a look around the side.
I guess the bell is broke.
Come on. I told you there's nobody home.
Will you stand by for...
Hey, fellas. There's a whole flock of doors over here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Case this garden, huh?
Yeah, this is where they sit on their patio.
It's open. Wait a minute. I gotta stop the florist.
What are you doing?
Don't you know it's always polite to bring your girl flowers?
Hey, maybe I ought to buy my girl a box of candy.
Not me. You guys are suckers of blowing all your dough in presents.
Boy, what a joint.
Yeah, and this is only the vestibule.
Are you sure this is the right spot?
Oh, sure, I'm sure. Look. There's one of the gals. She's got dead aim on you, Frankie.
Are you kidding? I've seen better mugs than that around a short bear.
Veronica Lake, eh? Dorothy L'Amour, eh? If Boris Karloff had a grandmother, that's it. Come on, let's get out of here.
Oh, now, wait a minute, will you? Barney.
Come on, Barney.
You're not going to leave me here holding the bags.
Bags is right.
Well, beauty's only skin deep. Let's peel them a little.
I suppose you'll come flying down the stairs on a broomstick.
Cornelia, do you think I ought to serve them on a silver platter?
Tell her to cancel that short order. We're leaving. Come on.
Oh, wait, they're fixing appetizers for us.
Well, we had no lunch. Maybe we,
Maggie, dear, did you take my cold cream?
Steady, men, steady.
That ruined my appetite. Let's go.
Mine, too. Let's get out of here.
No, don't go, fellas. Please, we'll stick together. Nothing can happen if we stick together.
Well, if it'll keep you out of the guardhouse.
I'll tell you what, we'll stick so close together they'll have to blast us apart.
Yeah, one for all.
And all for one.
And none for them.
Too bad you cows couldn't come down here and give me a hand. Oh, hello. Jerry, I'm so glad you could come. I'm Maggie Watson.
Maggie, this is Frankie Burns and Barney Hilliard.
How do you do?
Hello. How do you do? I brought you some flowers.
Oh.
I thought you'd rather have fresh ones.
Oh, how perfectly sweet. Will you just put them in the pot out there?
Pot.
And I brought you a box of candy.
Oh, you shouldn't have done that.
And I brought me. Where'll I put it?
Just put it down anywhere. Well, won't you have a seat?
Thank you.
Nancy's out on the terrace enjoying the scenery and smelling the flowers. Wouldn't one of you like to see the panorama with Nancy? I say, wouldn't one of you like to see the panorama with Nancy?
We'd love to. Excuse us.
What are you three, the awkward squad? Oh, just a minute, boys. I want you to meet my very good friend, Cornelia Pigeon. This is Frankie, Barney, and you know Jerry.
How do you do?
How do you do?
Shall we sit on the love seat? Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, you'll have to take them all, dear. They don't come apart.
You mean they're stuck together?
No, darling, we're the ones who are stuck.
I'm getting tired of sniffing those stinking flowers.
Oh, Nancy. This is Nancy Collister. This is Jerry, Frankie, and Barney.
Hello.
Hi.
I don't suppose it matters which is which.
Not at all. Just get a knife and cut one off for yourself.
You boys all drink out of the same glass?
No, we're hooked up different. He's on AC, he's on DC, and I'm on sustaining.
Well, what makes you boys stick so close together?
Rubber shortage. We're all using the same girdle.
This is all very amusing, but either you boys stop stalling or get out.
Well, what do you want us to do?
Well, what do you boys usually do when you're out with girls?
Say, look, fellas. Remember that house party we went to in Brooklyn a few weeks ago? Now, think hard.
You mean that one out in Flatbush?
That's right. And remember how we took the girls for a walk in the garden?
Oh, yeah.
And there was a beautiful moon, and the orchestra was playing sweet music.
And then?
And then we sat the girls down on a bench.
And then?
And then?
Well, don't tell us. Show us.
It's better with music.
Better have a little business conference.
Me?
You.
Right now?
Right now.
This will be collective bargaining.
Oh. Sit on them. That'll hold them down.
Don't be bashful, Frankie.
I know I'll hate myself in the morning.
But...
Now, look. I don't intend to waste this bait on fish that won't even nibble. Give me back the $50 and we'll call the whole thing off.
Oh, well, give us a break, will you? We can't get romantic with dames we've never seen before. What do you think we are, sailors?
How long do you three little bears need to hibernate?
Well, a little of that catnip might thaw us out.
Oh, no. You don't get another cent until we get some cooperation.
Well, I'll talk to the boys. But as the man said, you can lead a horse to water, but if he ain't thirsty, that's all.
I'll give you one more chance. Come here. There's a bar in there. Maybe the boys need a little priming.
Yeah, maybe they'll be better as blind dates.
Isn't this fun?
My, but you've got hard arteries.
Hey, playboys, come on the double.
Coming, coming.
Come into the saloon. I want to talk to you.
That's all, brother. You can count me out.
Me too. Mother's Day is over. I'm going back to camp.
Oh, now, wait a minute, fellas, will you? We'll give you your oats later. Oh, a fine couple of soldiers you guys are, running out in a couple of women. Why can't you be strong? Why can't you be romantic? Why can't you be nearsighted?
Samson was strong. Look what happened to him.
So what? He just got a GI haircut. They're just bluffing. They just want to play with fire. They don't want to cook.
Nancy will cook.
They can sizzle for all I care.
Oh, come on, let's have a couple of drinks on the house. We'll feel better.
Oh, no. When I drink, I don't know what I'm doing. And I want to know what I'm doing. Come on, Barney, let's go.
So, welching on the deal. All right, but first I have a little rebate coming.
Rebate? Yeah, what's she talking about?
Oh, I was going to tell you about that.
Hand over that 50 bucks.
Maggie, we don't need these squares. I can handle a deal myself. Maggie, I've got a wonderful idea. Brilliant. Oh, pardon me, stranger. Maggie, come on, let's dance.
Did you hear what I heard?
Yeah, $50.
Well, shall we rock it?
I'm not paying $50 for any dancing lessons.
Oh, well, don't apologize. Just wave the gum off your shoe. Hey, that's my record. How'd that get in here?
I found it on your bunk, but don't change the subject. What about that doll?
Yeah, I'm trying to pull a fast one.
Now, easy now, fellas. Don't get me worked up. I'd hate to see somebody get hurt here, especially me.
You know, a thing like this can give a woman an awful inferiority complex.
I hope Henry is having as much trouble as I am.
Our husbands.
Now, wait a minute, fellas. You don't think I gypped you, do you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't let money come between us. After all, what is money? Just something that was invented to make craft games interesting. Oh. Maggie, don't stand there. Maggie.
They're here.
They are?
Who's
not
here?
Never mind. Hey, come on. Let's
what's the big idea?
Where are they? After peasants.
I know.
How many tickets you got?
I'd give my heart that go ahead.
Would you like to try the two-step?
I said I never would fall in love.
Well, having fun, everybody?
Winnie,
Jill.
Somebody pour me a glass of iodine.
I thought I heard myself singing. You're not going to use me for chamber music.
Oh, now, Winnie, this isn't nearly as bad as it looks.
We were just trying to help Jerry raise some dough.
Yeah, we were just doing a little job for Jerry.
Did you get that? Just a little job.
Did you have to join a union?
We were quitting anyway, honey.
Yeah, Jerry was going to handle the whole thing by himself.
Oh, now, Winnie, you don't think I'd do a thing like that?
Yes, I do.
Now, see here, little girls. If these three brats belong to you, take them out of here.
Yes, they're no earthly good to us.
We don't want them. You can turn them in with your old kitchen grease. Oh. Here, Romeo, here's the wedding ring I bought, and here's a ticket for the engagement ring I hocked, and here's the $50 you earned.
But he didn't earn it.
So, you double-crossed
us. And he double-crossed us.
And he double-crossed us.
Yeah, and I didn't do myself any good either.
If you boys decide to go back on the payroll, you'll find us in the house. Come on, girls.
Cute.
Can I help it if women paw me?
Believe me, honey, it was strictly business.
Yeah, and we were getting to business.
I've heard about enough of this.
Oh, now, Winnie.
So this was a big military secret you kept from me.
Oh, now, don't take that attitude. Here I am giving up this whole deal and going to the guardhouse just for you.
Don't be so noble. All I want you to do for me is get out of my life and stay out.
Okay, I will. A fine, understanding little woman you turned out to be.
As far as we're concerned, you can all go back to those three Long Island hens.
Well, maybe we will, if that's the way you feel about it.
Oh, stop threatening us.
Go ahead, see if we care.
All right, we will. What do you say, fellas?
Sure, you might as well have the game as the name.
You tell Cornelia we'll be right over, but first I'll need a couple of drinks. Come on, Barn.
I'll go over and tell the three musketeers the deal is on again. Mix me a Mickey.
This is the stuff. I'm gonna keep drinking till Cornelia looks like Dorothy L'Amour.
There ain't that much liquor in the world.
See you later. We're gonna get loaded.
Well, that's the end of that. We may as well get going. As a matter of fact, I feel much better now that we're rid of those boys.
I don't.
in a way, Cornelia's right. You know, there's a remote possibility that our husbands actually went fishing.
You think of the weirdest things.
Oh, this room is just full of memories. When Henry and I were first married, he used to play me to sleep with his tuba.
Now he can't even lift it.
Hey, Maggie! Oh, Maggie! Oh, Meg!
We're up here, soldier. What is it?
I surrender, dear.
I'm sure it wasn't the boy's fault at all.
Of course not. It's those three women.
I'd like to horsewhip them.
Wait a minute. Come on.
Here we are. Come along, upsie daisy. Come along now, half pint.
That's the husband's. Husband.
Gee, this is a big joint.
Yeah, you must take him boarders, huh?
No, but it's an idea.
There ought to be plenty of fireworks when they get together.
You bet there will be, and we're going to be there to set them off. Come on.
Hasn't been open since Labor Day.
Well, brother, we'll open it with a bang.
Anyhow, you bet.
Boy, is this an elegant place.
Gee, what swell furniture.
Yeah, hey, I'll bet they're real antiques, huh?
Yes, my wife's hobby. She collects old things.
She collects young things, too.
Now, there's a lovely old museum piece.
That's my wife.
Oh, thank you.
Then we can all get together and play airmail.
Airmail? What's that?
Well, that's like post office, only in a higher plane.
Oh.
It's a joke.
Oh.
They're here.
That nasty laugh must be Julian's, the dog.
Who's Julian, a talking dog?
No, my husband.
Oh, boy, will he be surprised. I pity the poor stoop who's with you, your husband. Your husband? What? Where's the bathroom? I'll tell him I'm a plumber that's been drafted. Don't still...
He's a judge of character, though, Kip. He certainly is. Boy, I'd sure like to see him on the bench.
I bet he swings a mean gavel.
Hey, Beanie, how about doing the dance for us?
Yes, yes. Well, why not?
Well, I'd really love to, but I didn't bring my fan.
Well, how about an electric fan?
I tried that once. I was going great until some wise guy switched it on. Wow!
I wonder what Mr. Anthony would advise in a case like this.
Look at you. The man I love, the man I marry, my husband, you worm.
I'm going to divorce you within an inch of your life. And you a judge. When I get through with you, you won't even be elected dog catcher.
No, Corny, darling.
This is actually funny. If I wasn't so perfectly furious, I should be laughing. Ha ha.
Does she jabber-jabber like this all day long?
No, no.
Why don't you shut that china closet, you old battle axe?
Don't you call me a battle axe, you home wrecker?
Don't you call me a home wrecker, you
no,
old
wait,
battle axe?
Wait, ladies, ladies.
Let me out.
No, no, order, order.
Ladies,
order, order.
Now, stop it. That's enough. And you three little cream puffs, get out of here. Yes, now, go on.
You better get out. Go on, hurry up.
What's she got that I haven't got more of? How dare you open this house for an army of hoodlums?
Don't you think we'd better leave the army out of this?
Why, I don't know what you're talking about.
Who are these people?
Oh, just some friends that dropped in.
Yes, your wives thought they might need witnesses.
Oh.
Do you know what I'd do if I were you? I wouldn't let them get away with this. I'd go right over to Camp Arthur and find myself three of the cutest little boys in the army.
Don't even mention such a thing.
Hey, Jerry ought to have that fixed by now. What do you say we go back in there?
Yeah, they're probably waiting for us.
Yeah, okay.
Cornelia, we've always been too much in love to let anything separate us. Now, if you'll just overlook this seeming misstep.
Sure. Nancy, darling, you always understood us. You always said men were just grown-up boys.
Well, Maggie,
I hate to see them suffer. Let's be big about it. What do you say, Maggie?
Now, don't weaken, girls.
You girls! Hey, girls! You, where are you, girls?
Why, who could that possibly be? Were you expecting anyone, Cornelia?
Me? Oh, no.
Listen, Corny, we changed our minds about
this. Nancy, we're going to try and, who are you?
I am this lady's husband.
Husband?
Husband.
Who are you two guys?
We are these ladies' husbands.
Husbands?
Yes, who are you?
We're trapped.
Who are you?
We don't know.
We're incognito.
What are you doing here?
We came to see our girl.
Yeah, excuse us.
Pardon us.
Darling.
My little lovebird.
Get away. I never saw you before in my life.
We don't know these hoodlums.
Don't you get it, Judge? This is a cover-up.
Sure. Who did they call when they first came in? My name's not Nancy.
And I'm not Corny.
Now I get it.
Congratulations.
In my house. What a repulsive situation. What loathsome intrigue. You have us groveling, begging for forgiveness.
Oh, shut up.
Darling, I'm glad you're not a party to this horrible thing.
Well, I sort of came along as a chaperone.
Girls, let's not quarrel.
Well, the whole thing was your idea.
They're all in on it.
Are you lying to me, Maggie?
They're just a bunch of cradle snacks.
He was the one to start.
What are you doing in my house?
Your house?
Yes.
Isn't this Camp Arthur?
No.
Holy smokes, I'll be late for the parade.
No, you don't. I want to know the truth now. What are you doing in his house?
Well, I just happened to drop in.
And what are you doing with my wife?
I knew you'd get to the $64 question. Pardon me.
Oh, no, you don't. Oh, so you're Maggie's little playmate.
Oh, why would I want Maggie when I've got this?
All right, girls, let's face it. Jerry, stop lying. I'll give it to you very briefly. You three have been getting away with these barnstorming trips long enough. Now, we're up to bat. Yes, these are our three itty-bitty soldier boys, and we're out strictly for fun. And when these three fold up, we're gonna get three more.
What?
You heard what the lady said. We're going out to play, and if you get lonesome, get yourself an armful of this. Oh, great little pal. Never let you down. Come on, Maggie. Come on, Corny Doll.
Oh.
So long, fisherman.
And as for you, Judge Henry Clay Pigeon, I'm going out and get stinking from drinking.
Come on, yardbirds. Share that among you.
Well, I guess we had it coming to us.
Well, we didn't, and I'm not going to sit here moping about it.
That's right. We'll go out stepping. We'll show them we can have as good a time as they can.
Don't be silly. How can a man have a good time if his wife knows he's having it?
And this was supposed to be my wedding night.
Really? Is that so?
Uh-huh. She was going to marry Jerry. She's been going to marry him for weeks.
What's been holding it up?
Financial trouble, mostly.
Money, eh? Reminds me of my young days. Well, do you know what I was getting when I married Cornelia?
No, and I bet you didn't either.
I wonder where the three hags took them.
Why? The only place around here is that nightclub down the road. And don't you call my wife a hag.
Talking about the woman I love.
All right, all right. We feel just as badly about this as you do.
We could go down there just to keep an eye on them.
Say, that's a wonderful idea. Only we'll make them keep an eye on us.
Splendid.
That's right. They'll be more anxious to take us back if they think we're enjoying ourselves. It's simple psychology.
You've got something there, Judge. You know, the only reason we feel so bad is because we know they're having a whale of a time. Come on, we'll show them.
Did you ever hear the story of the...
Yeah.
Oh, you got that, huh? Oh, come on, Corny. Cheer up.
Quit pawing me, you nasty little boy.
Look! Well, they're here, all right.
Good. Let's go in and raise the roof. We'll show them we're not down the dumps.
Hey, Jerry, look who's coming in.
Uh-oh. This way, please. Laugh it up. Laugh it up.
I don't care if we never get home.
I should have met you 10 years ago when I was 18.
Yes.
I bet you're a dancing fool.
Well, I was always considered rather good.
There you go, holding hands again, Judge. Imagine holding hands with that hussy right before my eyes.
Don't you call her a hussy. Hey, what's a hussy?
Oh, that's a small hush, you dope.
Famous dance of love.
To bust out crying.
So am I, but I'm not gonna let Jerry know it. I'll crown the first one that doesn't look like he's having the time of his life. Now, come on, get happy.
What do you expect us to do? Get up and sing or turn flip-flops?
Why not? I'll get up and sing. I'll show that Jerry can't get me down. Oh, Captain.
Yes, miss.
Could you arrange for me to sing?
Let her. She's good.
Yeah, she's terrific.
Why, of course. We'll be honored. Just come with me.
Atta girl, Winnie. Come
get
along.
Out.
That's right. Crowd will love it.
Hey, Jerry. Did you hear that? She's gonna sing.
Well, what do you want me to do? Spray her throat?
Doesn't prove anything.
Proves how broken up she is over you.
Besides, she'll probably sing a torch song.
Mm-hmm. A torch song.
I understand that selectees are dejected when ladies don't neck tease. I could talk about love, and why not? But believe me, it wouldn't be so hot. So let's talk about frogs. Let's talk about toads. Let's try to solve the riddle why chickens cross roads. Let's talk about games. Let's talk about sports. Let's have a big debate about ladies in shorts. Let's question the synonymy of freedom and autonomy. Let's delve into astronomy, political economy, or everything biblical, a book of Deuteronomy. But let's not talk about love. Let's make with a speech like congressmen do. That ought to take care of an hour or two. Let's talk about storm. Let's talk about strife. Let's
talk about the bread you have to slice with a knife. Let's see some hot profanities with Hitler's inhumanities. It's our given sanities, the cause of his inanities. The threat that Hermann Goering and his mental toting fantasies. But let's not talk about love. Let's talk about drugs. And let's talk about dope. Let's try to picture Paramount minus Bob Hope. Let's start a new dance. Let's try a new step. Or investigate the call for any jitterbug step. Why not discuss my theory that Willow Nice a theory? Or bring a Jeroboam on and write a drunken poem on astrology, mythology, geology, philology, pathology, psychology, electrophysiology, zoology, phrenology. I owe you an apology, but let's not talk about... In case you play cards, I have some right here. So how about a game of gin rummy, my dear? Or if you feel warm and bathe in your whim, why don't you get into a bathing suit and take a short swim? But honey, I suspect you all are being intellectual, and so instead of gushing on, let's hold a big discussion on timidity, stupidity, solidity, frigidity, avidity, turbidity, Manhattan, imbecility, fatality, morality, legality, finality, neutrality, reality, or something else, brutality, bombosity, robosity, I'm losing my velocity, but I'm not talking about love.
Poor kid, you can see your heart wasn't in it.
Yeah, but everything else was.
Remarkable.
Come on, let's dance. Come on.
Oh, would any of you ladies care to dance?
Oh, right, yes.
You would? Oh, busboy, would you mind cutting in?
Well, if you free washouts want to sleep, you don't have to do it on our time.
We got sleepy on your time.
Voice. Sounds familiar.
No, couldn't be.
Two beers.
Yes, sir.
You know, you're just the kind of a girl that I could go for in a big way.
Hey, Jerry, do you recognize anything?
Well, I can't see the face, but that voice has a familiar stupidity to it. No, it couldn't be. There's no sawdust on the floor.
You boys won't need guns to fight the enemy. You can just bore them to death.
It's our secret weapon.
But we're not paying $300 for a demonstration.
$300?
What does she mean, $300?
Oh, now, wait a minute, fellas. Don't get excited. I haven't collected it yet.
Certainly sounds like some fellas from my outfit.
No, no, that's impossible. Tell me, are you married or going steady or anything?
Well, I have been corresponding with a fella, but he's in Africa now.
That sure is a break for me.
Oh, Sergeant, not so rough. Your medals are hurting me.
What's the matter with you, Jerry?
Let Jerry alone. Maybe he'll learn something.
Jerry, huh? Maybe I better look into this. Well, if it ain't the Three Musketeers.
Hi, Sergeant Wiggins. Fancy meeting you here, Sarge.
Never mind the soft soap. Where is he?
Who?
The Invisible Yardbird.
Oh, him. Invisible Yardbird. That's a hot one.
Oh, Jerry, stop pinching me under the table.
I thought so. All right, Walker.
Bang, bang. Fall down. You're dead. Boom. I got you. Fall down, Blimp. I'm a flying fort.
Oh, you mean fortress, Jerry.
That's what you think. I'm a military secret. Hello? Airport. Coming in for landing. P-38 with two tails. That's right.
Boy, he's crazy as a loon.
Yeah, that jeep knocked him cuckoo.
I thought I told you guys to take him to the hospital.
We did take him to the hospital, but we left him at the entrance.
Yeah. Followed us over here.
Look at him. Look at him. There they are. Oh, dogfight. Ah, we got him,
He seems all right for a while, then all of a sudden, he gets dopey again. Oh,
he's certainly been acting like a dope.
All three of them have been acting like dopes.
We only did it to humor Jerry.
Oh, it's only a flesh wound. Just a scratch.
Yes.
That's all. Don't worry about it. I was outnumbered.
I better take a look at that head.
Ah, it's a Nazi spy. Don't let him get away. He's a Jap. He's a jumping Nazi. He's a Nazi Japsy. Oh, you fifth columnist. Watch it, watch it. You fooled you. Ow. He's a Jap spy. He's a Jap Nazi. He's a Nazi Jappy.
It's Jerry's booth. There's a fight or something.
What's the matter?
Who hit him?
Look at the blood.
How do you feel, buddy?
Jerry! Jerry, your heart! What happened?
Oh,
it's you, you big brute. You didn't have to murder him just because he hit you with a piece of pie.
Honest, I didn't do it. Take her off of me.
He didn't do it, Winnie.
I didn't even know he hit me with the pie.
Call an ambulance!
You better wait, Winnie, until the doctor looks him over.
No, I want to talk to him now. Jerry! 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 Jerry!
Oh. Who are you?
Jerry, don't you know me?
Oh, sure.
But I thought you were in Kansas, Grandma. Oh, go away, Grandma. I want Winnie. Where's Winnie? We want Winnie. When was Winnie? Whatever happened to Wilkie?
Jerry, look at me. Who am I?
Oh, now, don't tell me. You're Eleanor. You've been away, Eleanor. You always go away. Please don't go away anymore, Eleanor. I've been doing my own laundry and dusting and...
Oh, Jerry, my darling, my dearest.
My day.
Just exactly what hit him on the head?
A jeep caved in on him yesterday afternoon.
Yesterday, huh?
Ixnay, don't give me away. I'm in a jam.
Oh. Pounding. That pounding.
Keep calm.
That rumble.
Oh. I'll take care of him. Oh. I know all about first aid. He shouldn't be sitting up like that. He may have a fractured skull.
I'll give you a hand. I've studied first aid, too.
Yeah, well, I better get outside and breathe
a little. Keep calm. Everybody keep calm. You should be horizontal.
Oh, no.
You've got to be horizontal. The book says so.
Yeah, what book do you read? Look, this...
But the book says you have to be horizontal. Oh!
Keep calm. Everybody keep calm. Give him air. Give him air.
And check my oil, too.
His face is red. Better get me some ice.
Ice? Ice? What am I, a highball?
What are you trying to do?
Putting a tourniquet around his neck to stop his head from bleeding.
It stops the blood.
But it'll strangle him.
Yeah, but it'll stop the bleeding.
You don't seem to know anything about handling heads.
Yeah, but I know how to handle a heel.
Catch my eyes.
Step aside, folks. Let me through, please. I sent for an ambulance. Maybe you'd better take him into the office.
Yeah, we'll carry him in.
Yeah, give us a little room, will you, please?
A little room.
Careful now.
Spread out, please.
Oh.
It's Mussolini. Hey, Ducci. Slip the hoochie to me, Coochie. Hoochie, good, yell, Ducci. Take him away. Take him away.
You better wait. You better wait outside, Sarge. You do things to him.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
How long do you think you're going to get away with this?
I don't know, but I'll be a dead duck as soon as that ambulance arrives.
We'll all be dead ducks if Wiggins finds out your head isn't bashed in.
Yeah, what do we do?
It's very simple. Why don't we just bash it in?
Yeah, that'd clear up everything.
No, no, that wouldn't clear up anything, including my head. Uh-oh, there's the ambulance. I gotta get out of here. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye.
Oh, all right, if that's the way you feel about it.
Hurry, fellas.
Think we can make the fence?
Are you kidding? I barely made the window. Hey, I got a better idea. We can cut right across to Camp Arthur. Come on. Come on, haul anchor and shove off.
Hey, stop!
That's our boat!
That's my boat! Hey, bring that boat back here!
When we get back to camp, I'll stick some adhesive on my head and tell the sergeant I'm cured.
Heave-ho! Heave-ho!
Why don't you heave and let me hold for a while?
I cannot tell a lie. I don't want to.
Hey, cut it out. There might be man-eating sharks in here.
The sharks around here ain't man-eaters. They don't like human flesh.
Yeah, well, they could take a bite and spit it out, couldn't they?
Hey, what's the hurry? The sooner we get back to camp, the sooner we'll be in the guardhouse.
Yeah, I certainly botched things up for all of us. Got you guys jammed up with your girls and with the army. I wouldn't blame you if you tossed me overboard.
I once saw a movie called The American Tragedy.
I'm just kidding, fellas. No, but I'm really serious.
Ah, forget it.
Sure, we're not blaming you. Just tough luck, that's all.
About that 300 bucks, I needed almost all of it to pay off the debt.
Oh, that's all right. You can keep it.
What do you mean, keep it? I haven't got it.
That's what I mean.
We struck something!
Boy, what a silly place for a fire plug.
What is it?
It's a periscope.
A periscope off a submarine?
It's a periscope on a submarine. This is a small end.
You mean there's a submarine downstairs at the bottom of this thing?
Yeah, and we're on the conning tower.
I didn't have enough trouble with the Army. I have to get in trouble with the Navy, too.
Well, what are we gonna do?
Just sit tight. Let them make the first move.
Well, then what are we gonna do?
Well, I guess they'll make the second move. Wrong Navy!
What is this?
What?
Luke.
I don't understand.
You don't understand.
It's the left, Waffy.
Reverse course. Head for the open sea.
Reverse course. Head for the open sea.
Full speed ahead.
Full speed ahead.
They may be coast guards, or what they call G-men. We'll take them out a few miles, capture them, and see how much they know.
Boy, oh boy, what are they gonna do?
They're taking us to Berlin.
Berlin?
We'll be ahead of schedule. Look!
Help! Help! Hey, watch out! We can get hurt up here! Watch out!
Hey, where'd you go, fellas?
Fellas! Hey! You cowards!
I got an idea.
Now's the time to get one.
What's that for?
Don't you get the idea?
Now, when they look through there, instead of seeing where they're going, they'll see where they've been.
I gave order to turn around and head for the open sea.
We are headed for the open sea, sir.
Look here, quick!
How did that happen?
You'll smash us up on the shore. Turn around! Reverse course!
Reverse course!
Now we're going places.
Where?
Look! Camp Adler.
Everything is fine, sir.
Now keep on this cruising level.
You wait, I'll fix you.
Look, they've got us spotted.
Yeah.
Hooray!
What's the big idea?
What do you think we're sitting on?
Don't be funny, soldier. What are you up to?
Confidentially, Sarge, would you like to buy a hot submarine?
Ah. You.
Shame on you. Wait till the paper hanger hears about this.
Ah.
Goodbye, darling. See you again tomorrow.
Wave goodbye to Daddy. Bye-bye.
Goodbye, dear. Goodbye, Junior. Goodbye.
Well, I was out for a whole year.